Today we are discussing about unit number 1. As we all know that unit number 1 is laser and optical fiber. So we have completed the first half, that is laser. Now we are discussing about the optical fiber. So here in the optical fiber, we are going to use this optical fiber as a wave guide. So we can able to see here in this slide, the optical fiber is used as a dielectric waveguide. So what is mean by this waveguide? Dielectric is nothing but an insulating. Dielectric is nothing but an insulating. So here we are using an insulator. That insulator medium is going to be converted as a fiber. That fiber is used in the communication process. That's why we are saying that optical fiber is a dielectric waveguide. Waveguide. Wave is the information. Wave is the information. Guide is the medium. The medium which guide the information from one place to the another. It's called a waveguide. So here we can able to see that the basic communication. So from this basic communication process, we are having two persons. So one who going to transmit the information and the other who going to receive the information. So we are having two ends. From the one end, we are going to transmit the signal. On the other end, we are going to receive the signal. So how it's going to happen? The signal transmission and the signal reception is going to be takes place with the help of the waveguide. So that waveguide is nothing but an optical fiber. So whatever the information you want to communicate, that information here we are going to pass through the waveguide. The purpose of the waveguide is to carry the information. In waveguide, we are going to carry the information in the form of optical signal. In the form of optical signal. So the whatever be the information, that information initially is to be encoded. That to be encoded. And after encoding the information, see here, in the left hand side, we are having in a transmitter. He is going to transmit some information. So the information which he initially transmitted is in the form of a sound wave. Audio. So that sound wave is started and it reaches the transmitting circuit. So the purpose of this transmitting circuit is to convert the information. So we are passing the information in the form of the sound. That sound information is going to be converted into the optical information, light information. Then the converted optical information is falls on the optical fiber. Then it has to satisfy the total internal reflection condition. Once this total internal reflection condition is satisfied, then the information will falls on the fiber, goes on to the receiving circuit without any loss. So the what the information you have communicated, that information without any loss, it will reach the observer, that is an encoder. So the encoder is the person who receives the information which was communicated by the transmitting person. So again, what happened after the transmitted circuit, the information falls on the optical fiber and finally it will reaches the receiver circuit. So here in the receiver circuit, these encoded signal again decoded. It means that the optical information, when it reaches the receiving circuit, then they will again converted into the audible signal. Then that information will be falls on this encoder. So this is the purpose of the optical fiber. We are using this optical fiber cable to transmitting the information over a long distance. It is used for transmitting information over a long distance. Here the optical fiber can also be called as a wave guide, because it's guiding the information, it carrying the information, it communicating the information from one place to the another place. Yeah, from this structure, we are going to learn how this optical fiber is going to be act. What is the purpose of considering this optical fiber? So from this slide, we can able to see that the information is communicated from one end to the another end. Initially, here the information is nothing but an electrical signal. We are passing the initial information in the form of an electrical pulses. When these electrical pulses falls on the transmitter, here in the transmitter, we are having internally three circuit. In the next slide, we are going to see that. In the transmitter, we are internally having three circuit. So that internal three circuit converts this electrical signal into optical signal, that is light signal. Then the converted optical signal falls on the fiber. When it satisfies this total internal reflection condition, then without any loss in the signal, it will reach the receiving end, that is the receiver. So here the receiver, also consisting of internal circuits, they will modify or they convert this optical signal into the electrical pulses. So the what initial input we are going to subject, that initial input we are going to collect at the receiving end. The conversion will be happens with the help of the transmitter and the receiver. Let's see one by one. Yeah. So from this slide, we are going to see what is transmitter. Transmitter, transfer the information, transfer the signal. So this is called the transmitter. So here in the transmitter, we are in one is interface circuit, second one is a source drive circuit, and the third one is a optical source. So what happens with these three circuit which was internally present in this transmitter circuit? Let's see one by one. First, the interface circuit. The interface circuit process the electrical signal. So what information initially we are conveyed, that has to be processed. That initial process is done with the help of this interface circuit. It processes the input signal. The signal may be the audio, the signal may be the video, the signal may be the voice, whatever it's. That information initially is to be processed. That processing made with the help of the interface circuit. Once the process of the electrical signal is completed, then it goes to the source drive circuit. So the source drive circuit modulate the information. Modulate in the sense they try to convert, they try to change the signal. So the varies the current to modulate the signal. We are passing the electrical current. First initial information is in the form of a current. That current has converted into the optical source. That optical source here converted with the help of the source drive circuit. And finally, that converted optical signal will reaches the optical source medium. So from this optical source medium, the information is communicated through the optical fiber in the form of a light wave. So here we have shown the transmitter. So in this transmitter, we are having totally three circuits: interface circuit, source drive circuit, and optical source. Electrical signal converted into the optical signal. Once the optical signal is converted, then they falls on the optical fiber, will goes to the receiver end. In the receiver end, we are having three circuits. One is a photodetector. Photo means light. Photodetector. Detector means the device, the light detecting device. So what happens? The information which was passed through the optical fiber, they reaches the receiver. Here in the receiver, the first circuit is the photodetector. So these absorbs the radiation, transfers light pulses to electrical signal. So they starts to convert the signal. So when we starts to convert, when we starts to modulate the signal, automatically, as we know that the signal amplification will reduces. So in order to increase this signal amplification, we are using the amplifier. So from the amplifier, it will finally reaches the signal restorer. The signal restorer is nothing but what information you have communicated at the initial stage, that same information after passing through this photodetector and the amplifier circuit, it will regain to its original mode. It's called signal restorer. So it converts amplified signal for interfacing. That amplified signal for interfacing is nothing but if I am going to communicate hello, that hello is nothing but an audible signal. That audible signal, it will goes to the transmitter. From the transmitter, they will convert it into the optical pulses. Then after converting into the optical pulses, they falls on the fiber. They have to satisfy the condition total internal reflection. Once the condition is satisfied, without any much loss, they will falls inside the optical fiber and they will come to the receiving end of the optical fiber. The receiving end of the optical fiber is connected to the receiver. So this receiver converts the optical information into the audible information. That same hello will be just reach the receiver end. So this is the process. So we know, we already talked about this term in more classes, but we have to see what is this total internal reflection, because without this total internal reflection, there is nothing can do from this optical fiber. So from this total internal reflection, we know that the total internal reflection is nothing but when N1 greater than N2, when the refractive index of the core is greater than the refractive index of the cladding, and when the angle of incident is greater than the critical angle. So it's called total internal reflection. We have to know what is the three mode of propagation in the optical fiber. The first mode of propagation makes the light to refract. So there the condition N1 greater than N2, I lesser than theta c. The second mode of propagation, the light falls on the interface. So when the light falls on the interface, the condition becomes n1 greater than n2, I equal to theta c. The third state, the third mode, when the light falls on the interface, that is when the transmitting signal falls on the interface, it undergoes the total internal deflection. So when it satisfies the total internal deflection, then the condition is nothing but n1 greater than n2 and I greater than theta c. So under this condition, the signal propagation takes place properly without much loss. So what I have informed, the same process. Here we are having the three modes. The light wave path, the how the light wave are transmitting. See, we can able to see the changes. We can able to see the changes here. So here we are having a three mode. The first is a mode A, second one is a mode B, and the third one is a mode C. So here these are three mode A, B, and C are considered as the light wave path. Light wave path. So that only mentioned here. Here we are having three path. First path, second path, third path. So when the first path is inclined at an angle I, then the ray automatically gets refracted. In the second path, when the ray inclined at an angle of theta c, they falls on the interface. In the third part, again we can able to see the variation in the distance from the normal line to the incident path. So here the incident path is I. When the incident ray is launched in this angle, in the particular angle, they will not refract, they will not falls on the interface, but they undergoes the multiple reflection. So that only we are considering here. So it depends on the path. So what directions we are going to consider, accordingly to that direction the light propagation will be takes place. See, here we are just passing the information on the axis. This be the mode number one, mode A. Mode A is nothing but the light falls on the axis of the core. The light falls on the center axis of the fiber. When it falls on the center axis of the fiber, it goes on linear without much loss. It's called as mode A. Mode B. So I am changing the direction. I am changing the path. So when I change the path, then we can able to see that the light strikes the core cladding interface, then it undergoes the multiple deflection. But the multiple deflection here in the mode B, we can see that it takes a longer length. But for mode C, we are just changing the direction further. Then we can able to see that the light undergoes the multiple reflection. Here the distance from one wave to the another wave is almost smaller when compared to the mode B. So we have just considering the core cladding interface. Along this core cladding interface, we are going to study this propagation mechanism. So we know the types of the optical fiber. The classification of the optical fiber is based on three mode. It's based on the material, it's based on the modes, it's based on the refractive index profile. The material, as we know, we are having two different types of the material, glass and the plastic. The core and the cladding are made with the help of both the glass material, or the core and the cladding are made with the help of both the plastic material, or in some cases we are going to consider the core as a plastic or cladding as a glass, or vice versa, core as a glass and a cladding as a plastic. So we are having a three different combinations here in the construction of the optical fiber. Core, cladding, we are going to consider only this through two mode, core and the cladding. Core glass, cladding glass, it's one type of the fiber. Core plastic, cladding plastic, is another type of the fiber. Core plastic or a glass, cladding, glass or a plastic. So these are just a different type of the materials we can use for our communication process in the construction of the optical fiber. The second mode is the step index and the graded index. So we are having two types of the modes here, step index and the graded index. Step index further classified into two type, step index single mode, step index multi mode. Graded index only the multi mode fiber. So here the modes are totally classified into three, step index and the graded index. Step index on further it classified into single mode fiber, multi mode fiber. Graded index are not the single mode, but all the graded index are belongs to the multi mode fiber. So this is the second just base in the classification of the optical fiber. The third base is the refractive index profile. So refractive index profile is the third base. So we are going to consider these all three basic modes to determine the optical fiber and its nature. So as I informed that material is a glass or the plastic. So we have already discussed about these things in the previous class itself. So just I am skipping this one. Number of single mode and the multi mode. So we are having two types of the mode, single mode fiber, multi mode fiber. So the single mode fiber, what is the single mode fiber? How we are going to classify these single mode and the multi mode? How we are going to differentiate these single mode and the multi mode? See, we can able to see here the white center circle is the core. Surrounded by this core, we are having the cladding. Surrounded these core and cladding, we are having the buffer coating. We are having the buffer coating. This is nothing but insulating medium. So when the single mode fiber is taken, so in the single mode fiber, the diameter of the core is very, very less. It's in the range of 5 to 10 micrometer. Only 5 to 10 micrometer. If the core diameter is very, very less, then the light communication is also less. It means that we are going to communicate only a single mode fiber. We are going to communicate only the single information. But in the multi-mode fiber, we can see the variation compared to the single mode. Here the core diameter is very, very large compared to the cladding. So here the cladding is seems to be in a small as compared to the core. So here the core diameter is about 50 micrometer. The cladding diameter is should be more than 125 micrometer. The outer protecting layer is should be more than 1100 micrometer. So here the core diameter is very large. That's why we can communicate more informations. We can communicate more signals through this multi-mode fiber. A single mode fiber means the diameter of the core, it should be in the range of 5 to 10 micrometer. The diameter of the cladding, it should be in the range of 125 micrometer. Uses laser light. So we are passing the information in the form of a light. So we are going to use only the laser. Infinite bandwidth. Due to this small diameter of the core, we are going to communicate only a single information. That information, it falls on the center axis. Otherwise, it can take a multiple reflection. But the mode should be a single mode. That's why we are using the word infinite bandwidth. It travels to a greater distance with a high speed. So this is a single mode fiber. It carry only a single information, but it can travel through a very long distance with a very high speed. So these are the properties of the single mode fiber. So these also we have already seen. The single mode fiber means only a single line. So we are just studying the parameters with respect to the characteristics which was given here. Structure, the core diameter is a 5 to 10 micrometer, cladding diameter 125 micrometer, protective layer 250 to 1000 micrometer, aperture value 0.08 to 0.10, bandwidth more than 50 megahertz kilometer. Here in the multimode fiber, we are going to communicate the information multiply. It means that not only the single information is going to pass, but instead of single information, we are going to communicate the more wavelength. Mode A, center, mode B, zigzag, and mode C, zigzag. So the last is just image. It's the completed image of the multimode fiber. We can able to see that not only we are having a single color, but here totally we are having three colors. So these are three colors is nothing but three different informations. So that signals are passed along the multimode fiber. When they satisfy the total internal reflection condition properly, then without any loss, they reach the receiving end properly. Here the diameters, the core diameter is from 50 to 100 micrometer for the single mode, 5 to 10. But for the multimode, it's 50 to 100. The cladding diameter is just above 125 micrometer, but for the single mode, it's around 125 micrometer. Then the outer protective layer. So the outer protective layer for both single mode as well as the multimode can be the same. We can consider the same diameter also, because it will never issue. It will never create any issues. Here we have to consider only the core and the cladding properly. For a single mode means you have to draw a small white circle. For the multimode means you have to draw a big white circle. So these are variations. If you know what to give, how to write, and how to define the variations, then it will be the easiest one for you to get the maximum mark. The parameters for the multimode fiber. So we can able to see the just information, not only the single information, but here we are communicating the multiple informations. Core diameter 50 to 350 micrometer. Cladding diameter 125 to 500 micrometer. Protective layer 250 to 1100 micrometer. Numerical aperture 0.12 to 0.50. Bandwidth less than 50 megahertz kilometer. So these are variations. If you know these variations, then you can write the types of the optical fiber. The third one is the refractive index profile. The refractive index is nothing but the step index. What is this refractive index? So here we are considering the core and the cladding with respect to the diameter. If you consider a single mode fiber, kindly consider the dotted lines. Then you can able to see when you join the dotted lines, it seems to be in a step. It seems to look like in a step. So that's why we are just called this concept in a step mode. That is a step index fiber. Like that, we have just communicating and we are doing it. So this is a process for the refractive index. We are having refractive index profile. One is a step index profile and another one is a greater index profile. The step index profile is seems to be look like in the steps. Greater index profile is seems to be look like in a parabolic image, parabolic mirror image. It will just look in the form of a curved shape, but it will look in the form of a linear shape. So this is a variation between these two types of the fiber. When compared to the step index fiber, the greater index fiber gives a more efficient. So we are considering this a greater index fiber because this greater index fiber produces the outcoming signal very frequently when compared to the single one. The next one, the step index. See here, I have just taken an image. The what parameters I have mentioned for the single mode fiber, the same parameter we can consider also for the step index single mode. Here, the diameter is going to be in a fixed. Whether it's a step index single mode or a ordinary single mode. See the input as well as the output. In the step index single mode, mode is single. So here we are having a highly amplitude input signal. That a highly amplitude input signal we are getting in the receiving end also. So that's why we are using this single mode fiber in most of the process, because we can communicate the information without much loss, and also we can communicate the information to very long distance. See the input as well as the output pulse. The input pulse and the output pulse are almost equal. We have to see only the height. If the height changes, then we have to think that the signal is lost. We are not getting the proper output. But here the what input level, that same input level we are getting for the output also. We can communicate this single mode information to a very long distance without loss. See, these are all the characteristics of the single mode fiber. It allow only one mode of light wave propagation. In single mode, we should not draw two lines. We should not draw 2, 2, 3, 4 lines. We have to consider only a single line. That single line, it at the axis, or it may be the zigzag one. But if we have to consider only a one mode, single mode, it allow only one mode of light wave propagation. It has a very small core diameter of 8 to 12 micrometer. It is designed for use in the near infrared. The most common are 1310 nanometer and 1550 nanometer. So these are all the wavelength region for the infrared frequency. So you use a laser light source. The information is passed in the form of a light. Mostly we are using the laser as the information. Higher bandwidth and a high data rate. Used for long distance communication. Fabrication is difficult and costly. So this is the drawback. The drawback for this single mode fiber is the fabrication cost is very, very high. And it is highly difficult for the fabrication. Here we are not having a dispersion. No dispersion. Dispersion is nothing but a loss. So in the mode, we are not having a loss. The what information you have communicating at the just a transmitting end, that same information we are going to get at the receiving end. So these are all the parameters. So due to these cost, and due to the fabrication difficulty, we are considering the second mode of fiber, that is multimode fiber. See here in the multimode fiber, we can able to see the input as well as the output. So here the input pulse, we are able to see that highly intense. But here in the output pulse, it's not shows the highly intense, but it's varying. The reason, here we are not communicating a single information. We are communicating the multiple information. So the multiple information, when they reach the receiving end, we can able to see that the information, it should be in the form of broad width. So these are the parameters for the multimode fiber. The core diameter is around 50 to 350 micrometer. Cladding diameter, it's more than 125 micrometer up to 500 micrometer. Then the protective layer, nearly 1100 micrometer. Numerical aperture, 0.12 to 0.50, bandwidth less than 50 megahertz kilometer. So its characteristics, the fiber that carry more than one mode of information, that's why it's called as multimode fiber. It has a very large core diameter. The most prevalent size is 62.5 microns. So the mostly commonly used multimode fiber core diameter, it should be in the range of 62.5 microns. So the multimode step index fiber is suffered from a problem to model dispersion. So we are having losses here when compared to the single mode fiber. That's why it's called as model dispersion, recent change. So use for short distance communication. We are using this multimode fiber only for the short distance communication. Here too, the information, it's optical information. We are using the LED light source. So easy to install and maintain. The fabrication is very easy. So we are giving more importance to the multimode fiber because of the fabrication and for easy installation and the maintenance. So this will be the last one, graded index fiber. The difference we can able to see from this figure. See here, the information, it's not seems to be an, a linear one. So we are not getting in a linear information here, but the information here, it's in the form of an, a parabolic. We can see the curvical shape, parabolic way. So this is in the graded index fiber. So this graded index fiber is a more efficient as compared to the multimode and the single mode fiber. So this is the process of the graded index fiber. We can able to see that index profile. So here, the index profile is not a step by manner. The index profile is not a step by manner. We can say that the index profile is in the parabolic way. Parabolic way. So it reduces model dispersion. In the first case, for the single mode fiber, we said that we are not having the dispersion. In the second case, we said that we are having the model dispersion. But for the multimode graded fiber, we are saying that we are not having the model dispersion. So we have to reduce the loss. We have to cut off the attenuation. So when the cutoff, when the attenuation or when the loss, when the dispersion is reduced in the communication, then the information will reach the receiving end without any difficulty. So this will be our main task. The our fiber which you are going to consider, that fiber should not have any loss. The fiber should not create any loss. That loss is something but called as a dispersion. So here we can able to see that comparison of the index profile. Here I have taken the three images. We can say that single mode fiber from the bottom to the top. Single mode fiber. So we can able to see that the red line. The red line is nothing but the signal. The signal falls, the signal process, signal just travels only at the center of the core. It's called a single mode. Next to the single mode, from bottom to the top, the second step, we can say that the multimode graded index fiber. Here in the multimode graded index fiber, see the processing of the signal. So here we are having a parabolic mirror image. That parabolic mirror, it's nothing but a graded index. On the top, from the bottom, to the top, we are going to see that multimode fiber. So here in the multimode fiber, we can just see that the information, it's completely reflecting, but that information is not just like a greater index fiber. It's a highly a zigzag and a linear one. So these are all the three just variations and the three differences in these refractive index profile. Single mode means a single image. Multimode means a multiple image. Greater index means it should be look like a parabolic image. The last thing from this unit is the application of the fiber. So where we are using this optical fiber? I have taken the medical application. So here in the medical endoscopy, we are using this optical fiber cable to diagnose, to detect the defects in the human body. So the construction of the optical endoscopic fiber is shown here. See here, we can able to see the source end. So we are passing the just optical information. That optical information falls on the inner fiber as well as the outer fiber. We are having two types of fibers here. Initially, the light, the information which we are communicating, that will falls on the outer fiber. So through the outer fiber, the optical information, that the light signal, will goes to the object. Object is nothing but a defect. The light falls on the object, the light falls on the defected area, then it get reflected back. That a reflected image falls on the inner fiber. We can able to see here that dotted lines, it's a shaded lines, shaded region. That shaded region here, it's nothing but the inner fiber. So from the inner fiber, it will goes to the receiving end. So when the receiving end, on the receiving end, we can able to see the image of the deflected body. That deflected image we can able to see through the help of the receiving end. So the receiving end carries the information of the defect. That information also carried in the form of an optical signal. So this is the working principle of the endoscopic laser. Endoscopic laser, we are having two types of the fibers, outer fiber and the inner fiber. Outer fiber initially pass the light and then it falls on the defect. Then it reflect back. That a reflected image, then it falls on the inner fiber. Through the inner fiber, it will goes to the receiving end. So from the receiving end, we can able to see the size, or we can able to see the impact of the defect, and accordingly to that, we are going to do the operation. So this is the just endoscopical optical fiber transition diagram. So I have taken some images, applications of the optical fiber. See, the doctor is holding the endoscopical fiber. So he is seeing just the defects. Actually, he is seeing the just a defected region. So here we are having the light information, and also we are having the two fibers. That inner fiber will shows the defected region. The outer fiber will make the light to falls on the defected region. See, we can able to see the how they are operating with the help of these endoscopic image. We can able to see that the doctors are not seeing the patient. The doctors are not seeing the patient. They are seeing only the monitor. So they are adjusting here. They are doing the adjustment in this endoscopical medium, and they are just treating the patient. In the second image also, we can able to see that the lady doctors, they are just observing the changes of the patient in the monitor, and according to that, they are doing the operation. They are just making the patient to be treated. So the third image also, this we can see that they are only looking their monitor. The fiber they have inserted inside their the defected region, and they are adjusting the fiber, and they are just treating the patient. The what they are doing, that they are seeing only on the monitor. So we can able to just collect the information. We can able to get the just defected information with the help of this optical fiber, with the help of this photon signal. So this is the just optical fiber endoscopical medium we are seeing here. So that's all for the today class. So almost we have completed one unit. So now I will show some videos related to these. So after that we can end our class. So let's see. First we see what is this. Just a minute, I will stop sharing. Yeah, now you can able to see this video.
Due to its anatomical structure, the human spine allows enormous freedom of movement and is at the same time the center of the musculoskeletal system. The invertebral discs of the spinal column play an important role in this as a connection between the individual vertebral bodies, and due to their soft structure, they are an important component of the function of the spinal column. Various causes can promote wear and tear of certain structures or lead to certain pain symptoms of the spinal column. One of the most frequent causes of leg and back symptoms is a herniated disc. This can cause the outer fibrous ring to rupture and the fibers and core material to exit into the spinal canal. Depending on the anatomical structures and location of the herniated disc, the symptoms can be very different. It is possible that disc tissue compresses important neural structures, causing pain sensitivity disorders and limited mobility. After a detailed examination, consultation, and treatment by a doctor, surgical removal of intervertebral disc tissue for decompression of nerve structure may be necessary. The so-called full endoscopic technique is a standard, minimally invasive method for spine surgery that allows the complete removal of a herniated disc and decompression of nerves through a small skin incision and little trauma. First, a guide wire is used to ensure the correct positioning of the instruments. Thanks to special instruments and devices such as the dilator and working sleeve, this procedure offers the most minimally invasive approach compared with conventional methods. An essential component is the endoscope, which guarantees optical control of the treatment at all times. This allows the procedure to be performed safely and least invasively. The herniated invertebral disc tissue is carefully extracted with the help of forceps to perform a decompression of the nerve structures. For coagulation of vessels and tissue, a specially designed electrode is needed. After the operation, the instruments are carefully removed. This least invasive endoscopic approach guarantees low scarring, low risk of infection, and extensive preservation of all anatomical structures and mobility, offering patients the fastest possible post-operative recovery. Full endoscopic spinal treatment. Safe, less traumatic, fast recovery. Revo Spine.
So let's see another one video related to our topic.
Graded index fiber. fiber design in which the refractive index of the fiber core is lower toward the outside and increases toward the center of the core. As a result, the average velocity of all light rays is similar, thus reducing modal dispersion and increasing bandwidth.
Yeah, that's all boys. If you have any doubt, we can clarify your doubt. You can ask your doubts. Why the attendees are very, very less? Totally we are having more than 65 students, but the attendees are only 29. What happened? Only 29 candidates are present. Why the attendance are getting very, very low day by day? If any reason, if you have any doubt, you can ask your doubt. Otherwise, we can end our class.
Thank you, sir.